Hey guys, Matthew here, and in this video, I'm going to show you a simple fix on how you can resolve this kind of issue with Outlook, where you open Outlook and it shows up this error message, like the OSD file cannot be accessed. So I'm gonna walk you through step by step on how we can fix that and reset up your account, okay? So let's just close Outlook first. So let's open it again here and see that's the error. So let's close it, make sure it's not running. And what you're gonna do is go to control panel first, all right? And then here, you'll see mail 32. Usually it's mail 32 and you'll see Outlook 2016 in there. But if you don't see that, you're probably on the category view. So just search on the upper right hand side. You see the search box in there. So just search mail and click on it. So, by the way, if you have multiple Outlook installed, if you have 2007 and then 2016 at the same time, you have to make sure that you're clicking on the right mail option, because you'll see here mail and then mail 32 Outlook 2016. So, if you're working with 2016, make sure you click on that. All right. So, it's actually because the OSD itself is corrupted and the profile is corrupted, so we have to create a new profile and start to reset up your account. So this is the existing profile right now, which is corrupted. So what I'm gonna do is I can add a new one and you can get rid of the other one later. So let's say new. So once you've done that, it's gonna ask you right away to set up your account. So you can do the automatic way of doing that. This usually works with Outlook.com emails or Office 365 accounts, which supports Exchange Server or Exchange ActiveSync. But if you're like setting up a Gmail account, you can go manual. But in this case, I'm gonna set up my Office 365 account. So just hold on. Okay. So now it's setting up. So let's just wait for this one here. Okay, so it's done configuring my email account. So I'm just gonna click finish, or if you wanna add more, you can do that. But I'm gonna click finish right now. So notice that we now have two profiles. So this is the new one and this is the old, which has the corrupted OSD file. So you have to check here. You have to make sure that always use this profile. You need to make sure that you select the new profile. So you can leave the Outlook if you think you have really important emails in there that are not synced to the server. You can leave that for backup purposes. But if you think that you don't need that, just go ahead and remove. So I'm gonna do that right now. Just gonna remove this and it's set to new. So now when I open Outlook, it should pull up the new profile with my account set up. So I'm gonna do that right now. I'm gonna open Outlook. The profile will run for the first time and it's gonna start to load. This might take a few minutes, so let's just wait for this one. Okay, there you go. Now we have the Outlook running without any errors and I have my account there working. So let's close this again and let's just close this and make sure that it's working. So closed it and now let's reopen Outlook. There you go. No more errors. All right, that should be it. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. I hope you liked it. And if you do, please be sure to hit that like button and share this video with your friends. Thank you and have a good time.